We've taken an active approach to control city costs by researching and finding a plan that offset 30% plus increases 2 years ago. The establishment of health savings accounts and implementation of high deductibles contribute to cost control then and now. A few years ago, the union actively researched and worked to change retiree health care with the management's assistance. The result was a significant reduction in yearly cost to the city. The city faces many challenges to finalize the 2010 budget. Working together with collective ideas from city employees, residents, the council, and the city manager, we can come up with solutions that will move the city forward, providing services to all.
On September 16th, 2009, I filed a request through the Freedom of Information Act for, I quote, copy of letters from the state of Michigan to the city requesting a deficit elimination plan for every year since City Manager Peterson has been here, as referred to by City Manager at July 16th regular City Council meeting. As of this date, I have not received a response to this request, and therefore it is deemed to be denied because it's past the time limit for a response. MCL 15.240, Section 10.1, gives me two options in this circumstance. I can submit to the head of the public body a written appeal, or I can commence action in circuit court. Earlier today, I submitted a written request appealing to you as the head of the public body. I am requesting this denial be reversed in that there's no reason it should have been denied.
In the newspaper, it said they were considering to slowing down or changes to the snow removal. Because I can't live at my property without not having someone come up there and snowplow. And last year, when I was snowed in, I had a suggestion that I snowblow my neighbors. I'm 70 years old. I don't snowblow for anybody except Ish.
Within the last few years, this elected body has taken on enormous amount of capital outlay projects that are happening simultaneously. To fund all these projects would be complex, even in good economic times. It would reflect proper stewardship of tax dollars to temporarily stop all of these large projects, including the Jackson Park, the Miners Park, the Corey Street, City Hall, and the Fire Hall repairs. I ask you to consider to reevaluate the priorities of these projects to reflect the current chaos in the central government.
Between 1997 and 2008, local property taxes and state shared revenues increased by 38.26%. And during the same time period, wages, pension costs, social security costs, and insurance costs increased 59.84%. Now let's get those two figures in context. The revenues went up by 38%, our costs went up by 59%. While the number of full-time employees that we have here in our city decreased from 51 down to 38. So even though we have fewer employees, our costs are that much greater. Clearly, this trend cannot continue, and I advocate cost controls and reductions as opposed to seeking higher fees, higher charges, or taxes upon the businesses or residents of this community. The state of Michigan, its legislative leadership, and members of the legislature have failed this community in meeting their promises and finding a way to achieve a prosperous Michigan. They have not only failed us, they have failed everybody in this state. These failures are producing difficult choices for local decision makers who provide the services residents need and want. These systematic and structural problems need to be addressed and all politics put aside to best serve the residents and the businesses of this community and of the state of Michigan.